In 2004, at the age of 17, Kayla Martell founded her first organization. She started Pledge, people learning to eliminate drugs by gaining education. Having lost a friend to drugs, she thought, who better to start a mentoring program than a teenager who has seen the realities of drug abuse? Over 2,000 lives have been impacted by Pledge. The program was implemented into after-school programs statewide. In 2005, as she began her college career, she founded her second organization. Caps for Gaps, or Youth Alopecia Patients, educates people on the effects of alopecia, as well as provides hats to children with disease. In 2006, Kayla went on to begin her pageant career by winning the Miss Sussex County title and placing fourth runner-up in the Miss Delaware pageant. Kayla uses her crown much like a megaphone, making her voice heard and speaking for those who cannot speak for themselves. What makes Kayla so special is that she has entered these pageants without a wig, as Kayla suffers from alopecia too. Through Gaps for Gaps, Kayla travels to various groups educating participants on alopecia and helping them to make hats for patients in Children's Miracle Network hospitals and local support groups. She has formed relationships with the National Alopecia Arena Foundation and the Children's Hospital of Philadelphia. Kayla has been featured on NBC News, National 4-H News, and on KidsHealth.org, just to name a few. She is involved with numerous volunteer groups, including 4-H, and has been honored with numerous awards, such as the President's Volunteer Service Award and the Prudential Spirit of Community Award, which was presented to her by General Colin Bowen. Kayla realized that she wanted to make a career out of what she spent most of her free time on, volunteering. She stated that none of her volunteer employment experiences felt like work. Martell resides in Milford, Delaware. Ladies and gentlemen, Kayla Martell.
My roots stem from from Delaware 4-H, and I know there are probably some of you who have been involved in 4-H.
All right.
And without my values that I learned from 4-H, I wouldn't be able to be honored in front of you today. I learned how to write grants in 4-H and create curriculum for different programs, and I learned networking in 4-H, and I'm just blessed to have met all of the people that I did. And I also need to thank my mother, who is here with me today. She traveled from Delaware with me. I won't say her age, but if she were just a teeny weeny bit younger, I think she should be up on the stage, because she volunteers so much more than I do, and she just taught me everything that is important about helping others, and I would never have thought at the age of 10 that I needed to help other people in the situation that I was in if it were not for her. And she is the strongest and most amazing person that I know, and she continues to inspire and amaze me, and she has dedicated her life to helping other people, including in her full-time job. My father, who's watching, God bless his heart, on the internet, hopefully. I don't know if he could even find the internet button on the computer. I think he's watching right now. So, Dad, I love you, and thank you so much for tuning in Delaware. I also want to thank the Miss Delaware organization, Brittany, Laura, and everyone who has helped me. As I said, I'm competing a week from today, so keep your fingers crossed for the next 7 days. And if all works out well, then you'll see me on ABC at the Miss America pageant next January. But I just have to thank everyone who's really supported me, and my boyfriend Kevin, who luckily is willing to sacrifice most of his time with me so that I can be out doing all of the things that I do. And also three young ladies who have alopecia like myself, or well, two of them do, they have been an inspiration to me and keep me going every day, Liliana, Isabella, and Megan. They've really taught me that to the world you may be one person, but to one person you may be the world. And I think every day about the decisions that I make and how it will impact not only myself, but also them. And they are the reason that I do everything I do, and I think they're tuning in tonight if they're still awake. And I want to thank you all for honoring me. It's a true blessing, and I want to thank God for even giving me the family and the support that I've had over the past 21 years. So thank you all. I hope I get to meet at least half of you while I'm here. And just keep on doing what you do, because as I said, you continue to inspire all 10 of us who are being honored here today. And I wish that each and every one of you could be receiving an award as well. So thank you very much.